over the last year, despite claims of going to fight the opioid epidemic, it hasn't really worked out thus far. Jump in overdoses shows opioid epidemic has worsened. So, rather than making things better, they've made it worse at this point. There's more bad news about the nation's devastating opioid epidemic. In just 1 year, overdoses from opioids jumped by almost 30%, according to a report released Tuesday by the CDC. The overall increase in opioid overdoses seen in hospital emergency rooms between the third quarter of 2016 and the third quarter of 2017 occurred across the nation. Some parts of the country experienced far greater increases, while few have reported declines, the analysis shows. And if we scroll down here, you can see the graph. Opioid overdose rates rose across the country. The red line being the Northeast, the blue being the Midwest, or correction, the blue being the West, the yellow being the Midwest having the largest spike, the Southeast being orange, and the greenish color teal being the Southwest being the lowest. We have an emergency on our hands, says Acting CDC Director Ann Shewchat, or Shewchat. I know I screwed up the name, I apologize. The fast-moving opioid overdose epidemic continues and is accelerating. The largest regional increase occurred in the Midwest, which saw a 69.7% jump in opioid overdoses, according to the report. The jump was driven in part by a 109% increase in Wisconsin. My God. Overdoses increased 40.3% in the West, 21.3% in the Northeast, 20.2% in the Southwest, and 14% in the Southeast. We saw, sadly, that in every region, in every age group of adults, in both men and women, overdoses from opioids are increasing, she said. I've got nothing funny to say about this because this is a serious problem and needs to be taken care of. So if you're expecting jokes and funny video clips in this video, sorry. The latest data could underestimate the overdoses because many of the people who overdose never end up in the emergency room. It might be even worse, she says. The report didn't specify why overdoses vary across the country, but one factor is probably the differences in availability of newer, highly potent illegal opioids such as fentanyl, which have been flooding the country in recent years, she said. We think that the number of people addicted to opioids is relatively stable, but the substances are more dangerous than 5 years ago. The margin of error for taking one of these substances is small now, and people may not know what they have. The supply of those more dangerous drugs is increasing faster in some parts of the country than in others, which may help explain the geographic variations. Overall, as a nation, we are still failing to adequately respond to the opioid addiction epidemic. Overall, as a nation, we are still failing to adequately respond to the opioid addiction epidemic, says Dr. Andrew Kolodny, co-director of opioid policy research at Brandeis University. It's concerning that 20 years into this epidemic, it's still getting worse. The number of Americans experiencing opioid overdoses is still increasing. I happen to know one reason that people turn to illegal substances: pain. People that tend to get addicted to painkillers, not all, but a good portion of them, it's because they can't get proper medical treatment for something that's causing them pain, so they take painkillers that they can get, which sometimes, if used improperly, are addictive, which could then eventually lead to an addiction, which would then lead to something harder, such as opioids and so on. So I think we could trace the issue back to the healthcare system. But I mean, this is just a theory. Although the Trump administration recently declared the epidemic to be an emergency, a significant increase in funding is urgently needed to treat Americans addicted to opioids, Kolodny says. It's kind of like pointing to a burning building and saying, oh, there's a fire there, there's an emergency, and then not calling the fire department and watching it burn down. There's been a lot of talk from Congress and from the administration and a recognition that we need to do something about this problem, but nothing yet has happened. Others say the key is integrating addiction treatment better into the healthcare system. For example, emergency room staff need better training to make sure addicts get follow-up addiction treatment, says Jessica Halsey-Nichol, president and chief executive officer of the Addiction Policy Forum. Too often, addicts are simply revived and sent home without follow-up care, only to overdose again, she says. Yeah, that's not inaccurate. We can use this near-death experience. Use it as a moment to change the person's life, she says. The latest analysis is an attempt by the CDC to track the opioid epidemic more closely. Previously, the agency looked at death from opioids, which lagged behind reports from emergency rooms. We wanted more timely information. The analysis was based on about 91 million emergency room visits that occurred between July 2016 and September 2017, including 142,557 visits that were suspected opioid overdoses. That survey showed an increase of 29.7% in 52 jurisdictions in 45 states between July through September 2016 and the same period in 2017, according to the report. The researchers also analyzed 45 million emergency department visits that occurred in 16 states during the same period, which included 119,198 suspected opioid overdoses. That analysis showed a 34.5% increase between the same periods in 2016 and 2017. Those increases vary dramatically from state to state, even within a region. For example, overdoses increased 105% in Delaware compared with 80.6% in Pennsylvania and 34% in Maine. Overdoses may have actually slightly decreased in Massachusetts, New Hampshire, and Rhode Island. In Kentucky, the CDC's analysis showed a 15% drop in overdoses. They may not be much, but at least they dropped. Because those are people that didn't overdose, that didn't die, that are still here, and hopefully making better decisions in life. If you or anyone you know has problems with mental health or substance abuse, please call the National Helpline on the screen at 1-800-662-4357.